I used to be terrified of growing up. After all, what is there to look forward to in adulthood? All adults ever do is complain and do taxes. Why would I want to become one of those losers?
I wish I was a slave to an age-old trade.
But wouldn't you know it? Growing up happens, no matter how hard you try to avoid it. I guess I never thought it would happen this quickly. Childhood is gone just as quickly as it came. No matter how hard you try to keep things the way they are, nothing lasts forever.
Morning, loser.
You're obnoxious.
Hey, Pete.
Oh, hey, George. Why don't you help yourself?
Jamie said I can have some.
I said you can have some, not three bowls.
This is my best friend, George Goldman. We've been best friends since third grade. Everyone says that he's a genius, but I know that can't be true. If he was really a genius, he wouldn't hang out with me so much.
We gotta go film that psychology project. It's due tomorrow.
Aren't you gonna have breakfast first?
I just lost my appetite.
Would you see your reflection in the mirror or something?
I hope you get diabetes.
You can't get diabetes from food, stupid. That was rude!
Come on, George. Let's go shoot at the plaza.
I don't want to go to the plaza.
We're going to the plaza! Let's just go. Dude, you don't need this. Stop stealing my cereal. Alright? Let's go.
Cereal. Get any letters from colleges yet?
A few, but I haven't opened them yet.
Why not?
You know what they're gonna say? Dear random person we do not care about, we are sorry to inform you that we reject you because we have sticks up our butts.
You gotta stop running eventually, Peter.
George, I'm not like you. I didn't win the spelling bee 5 years in a row, and I didn't teach myself Mandarin for no reason at all.
That's true, but you got plenty of other good qualities. Also, I won the spelling bee 6 years in a row, so try and get your facts straight, please.
Well, well, well. If it isn't Tweedledee and Tweedledoofus, Google Moss.
This is Logan Carter, and his henchman, Benny Benson. He's a bit of a dweeb. He's hated me and George ever since we kicked him out of our friend group for ruthlessly pitting us against each other to the point of extreme physical and emotional pain. So yeah, not my favorite guy.
Wow, your insults haven't gotten better since the third grade.
Neither has your face.
What is it with people on my face today? Do I have a zit?
Don't worry about it. What do you want, Logan?
Well, I saw the two of you having fun and I just thought I'd ruin it.
Could you not? I really don't feel like dealing with you today.
Oh, don't feel like dealing with me? It's like the third grade all over again.
You're still not upset about that, are you?
You guys kicked me out of your friend group! I sat alone at lunch for 3 years!
You know what you did?
Well, I haven't a clue!
First of all, who talks like that? Second of all, you made me and George fight with clubs!
I took a driver to the balls. I couldn't sit for 2 weeks.
Well, I don't see a problem with that.
Never let me play with clubs.
Shut up, Benny.
Listen, Beavis and Butthead, if you're done, me and George have to go work on a project.
My Beavis, sorry, my Butthead.
Your Butthead.
I thought it was Beavis.
Your Butthead! I just don't understand the purpose of urinals, man. They're just like toilets, but you can't poop in them.
That is the stupidest thing I've ever heard. You are stupid.
I prefer the term non-traditionally intelligent.
That makes no sense at all. Hey, Pete, I was wondering if I could talk to you about something.
Wait, can I guess? You're about to pronounce your dying love for me after all these years.
All right. No. I'm just gonna move over here now. I actually wanted to talk to you about the fact that I got a letter from Stanford this morning.
Stanford? As in your dream school? Is it just like financial aid packet or something like that? You know, the stupid mail that you get from them all the time?
No, actually, it was a acceptance letter. I got in.
George, that's great. Congratulations. You're not going to be a failure after all. But that's going to be a pretty far commute for you.
Well, I wouldn't be commuting, Peter. I'd be living there.
So what do you mean?
Well, California, it's across the country, Pete. I can't just be living there and... You're joking, aren't you? I hate you so much.
I couldn't resist, man. So when do you leave?
I'm supposed to be there by August 15th.
Wow, that's only a few months away. I guess we'll just have to make the most out of the time that we have left.
Well, how are we going to do that?
I don't know. I don't have any ideas. You're the smart one here.
Well, I don't even know if I'm going to go anyway, so...
You should. This is an opportunity of a lifetime, man.
You sure you're all right with it, man? Because if you don't want me to go, I won't go.
Don't be stupid. Of course you should go.
Thanks. As long as you're perfectly all right with it, though.
Absolutely.
I was not okay with it. I was happy for George, really. But I couldn't help but feel like my life was slipping right through my fingers. Truthfully, I was not in a good place. I was going to miss my friend, but most of all, I was afraid that I wasn't good enough to follow in his footsteps. In that moment, I made a decision. I wasn't going to worry about my future just yet. After all, life goes on. For now, I just want to have a good time. And I happen to know a guy who specializes in good times.
I believe in America, in being as reckless as you want to be. I've heard about your parties. You've got to be the wildest guy out there. And that's exactly what I need. I need you to turn George and I into you.
That I cannot do. We've gone to school together for many years, and this is the first time we've so much as spoken. You don't say hi to me in the hallways, you don't tag me on Instagram, and now you come to me, on the day of the Sopranos marathon, asking for a favor?
I'm desperate.
You have no respect! You show some nerve!
Hey Danny, you and your friends want some cookies?
No Mom, we're in the middle of something.
Oh, you're playing Mafia Boss again?
We're not playing, we're acting!
Sorry, honey, go back to your acting. Have fun. Oh, and let some light in.
Fine! Ugh. Now, where were we?
You were saying how you were gonna help me.
Did I say that? That doesn't really sound like me. Well... guess it's time for you to meet the squad.
Like the Suicide Squad?
No, even better. The Celebration Squad.
Wait, that's a really dumb name.
Shut up. Just shut up.
So why did your creepy new friend take us to the room that kids go to make out in?
Don't worry, you drove those kids out weeks ago.
See, I told you you can trust him.
All right, but what's all this?
Welcome to the Celebration Squad!
That's a dumb name.
I told him that already.
I know!
Wait, what's Logan doing here?
Greetings, mortal enemy.
All offense intended, you just don't seem like the guy who would join something called the Celebration Squad.
Well, every now and then, even us, genius A-listers have to hang around the common folk. You know, I'm human too.
In other words, he showed up one day, and we haven't been able to get rid of him or his creepy little manslave since.
Actually, I prefer the term mandated junior assistant.
Okay, squad. I want you guys to meet our new friends,
Peter and... what's your name? Armando?
George.
Well, you guys already seem to know Logan.
Hi. Hate you both.
And next up, we have Wing Lee. Nicest guy you'll ever meet. But, you know, if you cross him, he will murder you. And, if you talk to him, he'll murder you.
What?
Next up, we have Dre Young. Unfortunate name, really, unless he plans on becoming a failed rapper someday.
At least I don't look like the backs of a baboon.
How rude! How dare you talk to our new friends that way?
No, wait, that's not...
Anyway, next up we have... Quan Cho.
Hey, Quan, nice to meet you.
안녕, 난 Quan이야.
You know, he only speaks Korean, so... might be a total jerk for all we know.
Don't worry, I am working on it, though. 나는 음부에 꽤 아니이다.
넌 병신이야.
I love this guy!
What about me? What about me?
Anyway, I think that's everyone.
What do you guys do?
Sacrifice children to the sun god Ra!
He's joking! He's hilarious!
Peter, can I talk to you for a second?
Sure.
Why did you bring me to meet these weirdos?
Thought we can make the most out of the 6 months we have left. And I know Danny isn't really that smart, but he's a genius when it comes to this stuff.
Really?
I said when it comes to these type of stuff. I know I may not be that smart or good at triangleology.
That's not a thing.
But I know how to have fun, or at least know how to find people who know how to have fun.
These guys? Are idiots. Plus, Logan Carter, really?
I know, but just trust me. Maybe they'll surprise you.
Hey, Drake and Josh, sorry to interrupt. Are you guys in or not?
Of course!
Awesome, let's go!
This is perfect.
What? I thought you hated them.
Oh, I do. But now that they're so close to me, I can destroy them from the inside. It's like a walk in the park!
This is where we hang, Edmano. It's a lot freer than a stuffy house.
Plus, there are ghosts that'll eat your heart.
So, you all learn how to have fun like moi. Well, you came to the right place, and I know just how to teach you. Let's get down to business and have some fun.
If you start singing, I'll have to murder you and your entire family.
But that's how they do things in every high school movie.
Can't we just show them what we always do?
What do we always do?
We throw rocks at trees. Anybody got a rock?
We could strangle pregnant cats for Satan.
얘들아, 우리 PC방 갈 수 있잖아.
What?
Hilarious, Quan. But I don't think we can find and train an elephant in that short a time.
Oh, come on, guys. You were supposed to throw the best get-togethers in the whole school. I heard about them all the time. What happened to that?
Yeah, we pay people to tell everyone that to make us seem cooler.
Wow, I can't believe I didn't see this coming.
Wait, don't leave. We know how to have fun. We just need a second to warm up. And I think I got something.
Like what?
No. Don't stop me now. Having a good time, having a good time.
I'm a shooting star, leaping through the sky like a tiger, defying the laws of gravity. I'm a racing car, passing by like Lady Godiva. There's no stopping me. I'm burning through the sky, yeah. 200 degrees, that's why they call me Mr. Fahrenheit. I'm traveling at the speed of light. I wanna make a
supersonic man.
Back there.
Oh,
oh, you know me, just being a friendly friend and friendly inviting you over to a friendly party over in my house, my friendly house. Yeah.
I thought only Danny can call squad meetings.
Well, yeah. It's just a party. Come to the
party.
I know you by now. You're obviously planning something.
Hello, me? You really think I would do that?
Seriously.
Why would you say that?
You're not really crying.
It's just so hard making friends.
Fine, just stop crying. I'll come.
All right, I'll see you at 7. You know, I'll text you the details. See you around, bud.
Hey, everyone.
Welcome, welcome, friend.
Where is everyone?
How about you shut up? Oh, sorry, I'm working on trying to not be a,
total jerk?
Yeah. Yeah, anyways, this is Mikasa. Take a seat, Pete. We got some, business to discuss. I have a confession. Benny!
I have arisen!
Where's my pear? I didn't invite you over here for a party.
Really? Because this empty room screams party.
We gotta talk about George.
What about him?
Frankly, I don't see the point of you guys being friends.
Seriously? You're still the same loser you've always been.
Peter, calm down. I thought we put that old feud behind us, you know? I'm talking to you openly, as a friend. Tissue?
You have 30 seconds.
Oh, you're serious? Okay, where do I start?
20 seconds.
Just think about it. George has the potential to go places. Like, he's already been accepted into Stanford. He's gonna be a doctor one day.
10 seconds.
And he's about to throw it all away because of you. For whatever reason, you're George's hero. He would do anything for you, including passing on Stanford. You can't let that happen.
You're just the same old jerk you've always been.
And this isn't the first time either. When George had the option to skip a grade in middle school, what did he do?
He stayed back.
So, and why did he stay back?
He told me he didn't like the kids in the grade above ours.
The real reason.
He didn't want to leave me.
You've been holding him back all these years. Stop keeping him from his potential.
I could try to be like him. I could be better.
No, you can't. Some people, like me and George, are meant for great things. While other people like you and Danny and Benny just aren't.
I can't believe I came over here. You're just as bad as you always been. I'm out of here.
Don't stand in the way of greatness. If you love your friend, you'll let him leave. Why'd you do that? I'm just getting even.
For something that happened 10 years ago.
They left me friendless.
You're not friendless anymore.
Shut up, Benny.
You have me.
I said shut up, Benny.
We need to talk.
Sure. About what?
You need to go to Stanford.
What?
You have potential. You're going somewhere in life. I'm not. I'm not meant to be grown up, to work at a desk job. I'm holding you back. I dealt with things by running from them. I realize now I was just dragging you down with me. I'm sorry.
Peter, I...
Go to Stanford. Don't be like me. Don't waste your life stuck in your childhood. George, just trust me.
Peter. Peter!
Go away, Mom.
Hey, Peter. George told me what happened. Were you high or something?
No, I just realized I wasn't meant to grow up.
Right. Listen here, Peter Pan. I'll get serious often, but you need to hear this. Do you know why I started the squad? It was because I was afraid of growing up, too. But then something changed.
What?
You and George joined the group.
Really?
Yeah, and I saw just how pathetic the two of you were, trying to run away from your problems. But I realized that's what we were all doing, just running away from our problems. You can't do that forever. Look, I don't know where you got this weird idea in your head, but you can and should do something with your life. Don't be like me. Don't be like the squad. You have potential. George has potential. Even Quan has potential.
I don't know about that.
Never let anyone keep you from going where you want to go in life, including yourself.
When George told me he may go to California, my solution was to turn to the Celebration Squad, to throw parties and stay out late. I haven't the slightest clue on how to become an adult.
I know, but maybe if you keep looking, you'll find it. I mean, I'm not saying the answer's just gonna come knocking on your door.
Peter? Peter, before you say anything, I need to talk to you about something.
George, what are you doing?
No, you need to hear this. Okay, we've been best friends our entire lives, and that's not something that goes away so quickly. Look, I know that you're afraid of growing up, but literally everyone feels the same way. I feel that way. Even Quan feels that way.
I don't know about that. Quan's a little, like, different than...
Well, he probably does.
I guess.
The point is, no one knows how to grow up. It's just something we all have to figure out as we go along. And I know it won't always be fun, but it's something we all have to do. And I'm not ready to do it without you. And I know that the future is a terrifying thought, but maybe it won't be so terrifying if you don't have to go it alone.
That was really sappy, George.
Yeah, but I figured you weren't going to get that kind of speech from Danny. Hi, Danny.
Hey, George.
How are you?
Great. Just chipper.
Perfect.
I would care if you brought me the parrot and I didn't have the answers to the history quiz.
You wanted the parrot, though.
No, I wanted to get 100 on my history quiz.
Hey,
you ruined
Logan.
Oh, hey, George, Peter, how's
it? Can it, Carter.
Well, what's going on here?
Peter told me what you did to him.
Well, I only told him the truth.
It's like the third grade all over again, except without the clubs.
Give me one reason why I shouldn't pummel you, Carter.
I don't know, maybe because I was right? Wasn't I, Peter?
I don't care what you were. You have no right to butt into our lives and tell us how to live them.
Enough! I'm tired of you two. You can be all chummy-chummy all you want, but it will get you nowhere in life. The longer you stick on to him, the less far you'd go in life, all right? You will be carrying his dead weight for all of eternity and be doomed to failure. I want you to succeed, George. Stop carrying him around. And as for you, Peter...
Enough! I've had enough of your bullying. Why do you have to try and ruin the lives of two perfectly good people? You're a horrible person and even more horrible of a friend. If anybody's holding Peter and George back, it's you.
Benny, what?
Shut up, Logan!
Good for you, Benny. Let's go. Come on.
Ouch, man. That sounded like you hurt.
Need a hug?
Get away from me.
Alright. You know, I'll give you one anyway. Hey guys, wait up! So, Logan was trying to get you to help George by abandoning him? That's stupid. You actually fell for that?
Shut up, man. I'm a sensitive person.
Well, at least you know how much of a sneezebag he is.
I think you mean sleazebag.
I don't think I do.
I think we should sacrifice him.
Very funny, Wing.
Is he serious?
I'm honestly not sure anymore.
Everyone,
I have an announcement to make. I decided on where I'm going to go to college next year.
Oh, yeah. Big deal.
Drum roll, please.
This fall, I will be attending Boston University.
That's awesome! Congrats, Pete!
I'm really gonna miss all you guys.
Aww. Aww.
Huh? Yeah, yeah, I owe all you guys, especially my best friend.
Peter, I'm flattered, but I've only known you for a couple of months.
Not you, Danny. George.
Oh, that makes more sense.
Congrats, Peter.
Thanks! I guess there's more to me than I thought.
Oh, I love you guys.
What in the name of Merriam-Webster? You can speak English?
Of course I can, you racist jerk. I'm sorry, Quan.
I used to think that running from my problems would solve. That if I wasn't ready, then I never would be. But I was wrong. Wish I was a slave to an angel. Adulthood isn't about being ready to grow up. Like riding around on rail cars and working long days. It's about learning to cope with the changes life throws your way. Lord have mercy on my rough and rowdy ways. Lord have mercy on my rough and rowdy ways. And we never have to do that alone. And in the end, we can look back on the past and remember why we are who we are. Don't make no difference if you sit or you stand. But some things last forever.
Is anyone in here?
Roomie!